Hi students, we are discussing solution part 1. In that we are discussing about important concentration terms and solubility of solid in liquids and solubility of gas in liquids. Henry's law related we are discussing. First, important concentration terms. Important concentration terms, we have molarity and when you are doing dilution, this three things will be important while discussing about colligative properties. That's why molarity, dilution, these three things we will go through it. Molarity, we have set up on this number of moles by volume in liter. Okay, number of moles of solute present in 1 liter solution, or we are using weight by molecular weight into 1000 by volume in ml. And many cases they will give weight percentage, volume percentage, weight by volume percentage, strength, like that. So if weight by weight percentage is given into density or specific gravity by molecular weight, if the weight by volume percentage is given into 10 by molecular weight, and if it is a strength is given in gram per liter, strength units. So these are set of formulas we are using to find the molarity. And same way, molarity we are using number of moles by weight of solvent in grams kg, and weight of by molecular weight into 1000 by weight of solvent in grams. And these are the basic formulas we have. Other than that, we have molarity and molality relation. That molarity is equal, okay, molality equal to molarity into 1000 by density into 1000 minus molarity into molecular weight of solute. Okay, same way, molality and mole fraction of solute, we take Kb by 1 minus Kb into 1000 by molecular weight of solvent. Okay. So these are important relations we have. During the dilution, what happens? Concentration will be decreases. We will dilution law we are using m1v1 equal to m2v2. So first we required these concentration terms for doing the solution lesson. Especially for finding the osmotic pressure, we required molarity. Finding elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, we required molality. So these are concentration terms we are using for finding the molarity. So, and molarity. Next, we are going to discuss about solubility of solid in liquid. Solubility of solid in liquid. So solid, we are adding liquid, then it will be form what? Solution. Okay, so solid we dissolve in a liquid, it will be form solution. So forward reaction we are calling as a dissolution. And backward reaction we are calling as a crystallization. Backward reaction is called as a crystallization. Okay. So in these reactions, okay, formation of solution, yes, what will be the delta H, delta G and delta S? These three things we have to know. So formation of solution case, what is the delta H, delta G and delta S? Okay, first formation of solution case. Here we have solid is solute and liquid is the solvent, it forming the solution. So in this case we have to break the interactions between solute particles. Okay, so to break the interaction we require, or there is a change in enthalpy, that is the delta H1. Same way, you have to break the interactions between the solvent particles, that required delta H2, and formation of interactions between solute and solvent, that is the delta H3. So when we adding solute to the liquid forming the solution, we require three types of interactions will be present: break the interactions between the solute particles and solvent particles, then a formation of interaction between solute and solvent particles will be present. Okay, so overall delta H, if you're taking it, may be positive or negative. It may be positive or negative will become, but formation of solution will be what? It is a spontaneous process. That's why delta G will be negative will becomes. Okay, and here delta S, entropy will be increases when you're forming the solution, because the solute particles and solvent particle orderly arrangement will be there. When you're adding solute to the solvent, the disorderness will be increases. That's why entropy will be increases. So delta S will be positive will be there. So next, what is the effect of temperature? Okay, on solubility of solid in liquid. So we know that if delta H will be positive, positive means what reaction? It is a endothermic reactions. So we, if temperature increases, solubility will be increases. And if it is a negative, that is the exothermic reactions. If temperature increases, then solubility will be decreases according to Le Chatelier principle. So this is the effect of temperature on solubility of solid in liquid. So what is the effect of pressure? Effect of pressure. So effect of pressure is solids and generally liquids are almost incompressible. So that's why there is no effect of pressure will be present on solubility of solid on liquid will be present. So these are some important points related to solubility of solid in liquid. First, we discussed forward reaction is dissolution, backward reaction crystallization. Entropy may be delta H will be positive or negative. Delta G will be negative, delta S will be positive. Temperature effect and effect of pressure we have discussed. Next, we are going to discuss about this one, solubility of gas in liquid. So solubility of gas in liquid will be explained with the Henry's law. Okay, here two types of way you can express Henry's law. First one, the solubility of gas directly proportional to pressure. Okay, so solubility of gas in liquid is directly proportional to pressure over the surface. Okay, so that is the first one we have. And majorly when you are doing problems, we are using this one, partial pressure of the gas. Partial pressure of the gas is directly proportional to its mole fraction. Okay, so partial pressure of gas, we are using KH into XI, or partial pressure of is equal KH into number of moles of component by N2. So KH here, Henry's law constant. Okay, here partial pressure of gas is directly proportional to partial pressure of gas on the surface is directly proportional to mole fraction of gas in solution liquid. So that is the Henry's law we have. And here we are getting some important points related to this one. So what is the KH? KH is the Henry's law constant, and it will be depend on which one? Depend on temperature, nature of solvent and gas. Okay, and if temperature increases, KH value will be increases, and KH inversely proportional to solubility. KH value more means solubility will be less will be present. And the next one here, KH value, okay, inversely proportional to solubility, and the KH value have the same units as a pressure, because mole fraction does not have units, so this pressure and KH have same units will be there. Okay, so So these are some important points related to the Henry-Stowe constant. Okay. And the next one, where we are applying Henry's law. Okay, applications. So first application we will find in a preparation of cold drinks. They are packed under high pressure and closed. So that is the first application. Okay. And the second application we can find in case of high altitude sickness related. So when you are going to the high altitude, what happens? Headache and vomiting sense, like some symptoms will become because the solubility of oxygen will be decreases in blood due to decrease in the pressure at high altitude. That is also this one application. And scuba divers, when go into the depth, what happens? The solubility of nitrogen gas in blood will be increases, and when they are coming up, the again gas nitrogen gas released in the blood vessel, and the formation of bubbles will be takes place, and it may cause serious problems, may cause death also. That we are calling as the bends. Okay, so bends formation is due to that, what, higher we are going to the depth, the pressure increasing, and when you are coming higher, normal pressure will be decreases. So that point will be again related to application. So to avoid that one, we are keeping that helium 11.7% and nitrogen 56.2%, and remaining O2 will be keeping to avoid the bends. Okay, so these are some applications related to which one? Henry's law. Okay, and we'll check one or two questions how they are asking. Okay, so if you are taking, they are given information, S2S gas is there, its solubility is 0.195 molar, then find KH. Okay, so they are given information, S2S is a one gas having rotten egg smell, and its solubility is 0.195 molar, find KH value. Okay, so in this case we already know that partial pressure of gas is equal to KH into mole fraction of gas. Okay, so they given information, what, 0.195 molar. Okay, that what is that mean? So number of moles of S2S will be equal to 0.195, and number of in 1 liter. 1 liter means from this one, what is the number of moles of water? 1000 by 18, 55.55 liter. okay, and number of moles, this one we are getting, so n S2S is 0.195, and n water will be equal to 55.5. So total, n total will become how much? So 5 and 4, 7 and 55. So 55.745 you are getting the n total. Okay. Now by using this formula, they have not mentioned about partial pressure of the STS gas. You can consider it will be the atmospheric pressure, that is a 1 atm or 1 bar. Suppose 1 bar we are taking, 1 kh in terms of bar, and number of moles 0.195 by n total is 55.74. So if you solve this one, you will get the which one, kh value 280.7 bar. So like that we have to solve the questions related to if they are given a solubility, you have to take, they are in terms of molarity given, 0.195 molar solution means 0.195 moles of S2S present in 1 liter of solution. So by solving that, you will get the 285.7 bar. Okay, and one more question you can check. Okay, they are given KH for CO2 solution is given 1.67 into 10 power 8 Pascal. Okay, and they also given 1 liter of soda water is there, and having the partial pressure of CO2 is given 1.67 bar. They are asking number of moles of CO2 present. So KH per a solution having the CO2 is 1.67 into 10 power 8 Pascal. If 1 liter of soda water contains carbon dioxide under pressure what 1.67 bar, what is the number of moles of carbon dioxide present in the solution? Okay. So whenever when we are finding a pure number of moles of solute, so in this case we can do what n total we almost consider as a and water, because generally water will be high amount will be there, and carbon dioxide will be very less amount will be there. So in this case what we get, partial pressure is equal to KH into N CO2 by N water. Okay, so partial pressure they given 1.67 bar. So 1.67 bar means 1.67 bar into 10 power 5 Pascal, in terms of Pascal area, because this is in terms of Pascal. KH is equal to 10 power 8 in terms of Pascal. N CO2 we have to find. We know that N water. Okay. So they are told 1 liter of soda water. 1 liter of soda water means number of moles of water will be equal to 1000 by 18. That is 55.5. So 55.5 MT. Okay. Next, this will be get cancelled and you will get 10 power minus 3 into 55.55 is equal to NCO. So therefore number of moles of CO2 is equal to 5.55 into 10 power minus 2 moles. So in this way you can solve the problem. Okay, so whenever they are asking number of moles of gas or weight of gas, in that case if they are asking weight, how you can find mass or weight? They ask me mass, number of moles into molar mass, that is equal to 5.55 into 10 power minus 2 into 40. So like that we can able to find the mass of. So in this way we can solve the problems related to which one, Henry's law constant related problem. And the next one, some important graphs also will be useful. So first graph, they are asking partial pressure of gas versus mole fraction of gas. Okay. So gas we are taking. Okay, gas you can take. Okay. And in this case we know that already partial pressure is equal to KH into XI. So that's why you will get the Y is equal to MX graph. Y is equal to MX means how it will be present. Line passing through the arch. Okay, E, I and X, I dot it. Okay, some cases if they are asking solvent, okay, this is the B. If they are asking related solvent, this is the 1 minus X, A. So, PD is equal to KH minus KH into X. This is minus Y is equal to C minus X. It is nothing but Y is equal to M minus MX plus C. So the graph will becomes like this. Okay. So here partial pressure of gas and mole fraction of solvent. Okay. This is the graphs related to Henry's law. One more graph also you can get. Log M versus log P. So how the graph will becomes? Generally M is represent, previous question we are seeing, molarity is given, means that is related to solubility. So we already know that solubility is equal to KH into P. So solubility place we are writing molality. Molality is equal to KH into P. So log M equal to log P plus log KH. This Y is equal to MX plus C. So how the graph will becomes like passing through this one. And here the intercept is 1, slope is 1, so that angle will become 45 degrees. And this intercept will be given log KH value. Okay. So these are some kind of graphs related to the Henry's law. Okay. So in this part, solution part, we discuss mainly important concentration terms and the solubility of solid and liquid, Henry's law and related some problems, and also we discuss how the graphs will be asked related to it. Okay. So we'll discuss liquid solutions and qualitative properties in the next video. Okay. Thank you.